What number is that? 20. Only 5 more to go. And you know what's even greater than this? It's only 6:25. Hi, it's Rich Russo, head coach of Bexley Cross. It's my fourth year as the head coach of Bexley. Goals are, our expectations are always high. We do always want to try to compete for a state title. We're looking forward to Granville, New Albany. We start off with St. Charles. We've got DeSales coming in. We've got a couple of teams coming in from out of state to play us. So it'll be we have a fun schedule. The schedule is always challenging. We're no longer a doormat. We're no longer a surprise to anybody. Everybody's coming prepared for us. There's no more, oh, we're playing Bexley, we don't need to worry about it. They worry about it now, which is a great feeling.
Oh, Bash, nice save. Oh, there you go, Lacker, and this quick stick.
White pulse, let's go, on the hop.
Okay. Yeah, you can be the best. You can be the King Kong banging on your chest. You can beat the world, you can beat the war. You can talk the guy, go banging on his door. You can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock. You can move a mountain, you can break rocks. You can be a master, don't wait for luck. Dedicate yourself and you can find yourself.
About 5 years ago, during school, a bunch of kids, we were playing lacrosse, like during recess. I wasn't really playing, I was just watching. Me and my friends were like, wow, it looks pretty fun. So later that spring, we signed up in sixth grade, and we played ever since. I just wanted to play originally because I just wanted to stay in shape during the spring, and eventually I started falling in love with lacrosse.
You can walk straight through hell with a smile. You could be the hero, you could get the gold. Breaking all the records they thought never could be broke. Yeah, do it for your people, do it for your pride. And you're never gonna know if you never even try. Do it for your country, do it for your name. Cause there's gonna be a day when you're standing in the Hall of Fame.
My biggest expectations for the team are that we can play as a team and not have a weak link like we did last year in a lot of areas. I don't want a team that's known as that team with the great defense or that team with the great offense. I want to be known as that team that's that great team.
Politicians be preachers, yeah. Be believers, be leaders, be astronauts, be champions, be truth seekers, be students, be teachers, be politicians, be preachers, be believers, be leaders, be astronauts, be champions.
It really begins Monday night when we come out here, we find out who really wants to play lacrosse.
Let's go, baby.
Are we ready? All right, bring it. If we play our game, if we do not make dumb mistakes, it is ours. There's no doubt about that. Okay?
Yeah, let's go, boys.
Let's go.
Go. We're
going
to take one. Go.
Go. Go. Go. Go. Go. One, two, three.
Lions.
For Pickerington Central, we had to really step it up. They had a big attack. They had D1 commits already, and I felt like that was a first G test.
Offensively, our attackmen, guys, you gotta help us. Defensively, we're fine. Guys, we're fine. We had one slide to the stick, cost us a goal. We didn't slide to the body.
So save us.
Well, after a pretty rough start to our season, being 1-5, I thought Wellington was a real good start to our win streak, and it felt good playing a team that we are obviously better than and just coming out strong.
Good job.
Was executing very well. Our defense slides were on point, and talking was great. So I just feel that really set the tone for our next few weeks of playing, and that's how we got that 5-1 streak.
Oh, that was a nice pass.
We started off, it was going a little slow. Then Kavanaugh came back, and I feel like that brought the team together. Our chemistry is up all the way, and I feel like we can really finish off the season strong. Our biggest challenge was definitely coming back off that 1-5 start and showing how resilient as a team we can be and that we have the skills to win.
Save us all.
Big win after Wellington. Feeling good about the way we were playing coming into the game against Hilliard. We knew it wasn't going to be an easy game, but I think we were ready.
Right there. That's the kind of team that you want to be on. Guys that don't give up. That was a great win for you guys. Great win.
There's not a better feeling knowing that you pulled it out. Guys, relax.
Hey guys, awesome first three quarters. Awesome. Okay.
Great three quarters.
Great three quarters.
Champions aren't people who get aren't undefeated or win every game or they're the greatest guy in the field. They're guys that get knocked down and come back. Kavanaugh was knocked down at Gahanna. He was knocked down by himself, not because of their team. He put himself in that position and he came back tonight. That's a champion. That's what champions do.
Woo! Good work, Doc. Woo! All
right. Guy pops up, he looks for pass here. You don't get the pass, you make the pick. The other guy comes, if he doesn't get it, you're done.
We went up for the first quarter, I think 6-1. We put up a good showing. Face-offs were pretty one-sided. The offense was just relentless on scoring. Defense was strong. We've never beat Grambling before, so this game really meant a lot to the team. The rest of the game, we were just fishtailing it. We were going back and forth. Taking the lead from each other. We really put up a physical effort against them. Throughout the whole game, we never let up.
It was a pretty big game. I mean, we had the chance to beat DeSales, and I thought we'd come up I mean, a little more on fire than we normally should have. I mean, not quite as intense as I would have liked, but it's good to play with all those guys. It's glad to see all the seniors get in for at least part of the game, and played with them for a long time, so it was really fun. Something. It's playoffs, baby. To sum it all up, Academy basically is our arch rival, and we do not get along, and that just makes it even better. Knowing that we're playing the one team we hate more than anything as our first round of the playoffs, and I think it'll be good.
Bexley means a lot to me because it let me, well, it was big for me coming back from injuries to be able to play.
and be able to play for coach I've been working with for years and in my hometown. All right, now that my senior year is over, I hope that the team can pick up where we left off. And I mean, this year we did a lot more than I expected. Hopefully they can just get better, keep on getting better.
Lacrosse gave me some of my best friends. I mean, we don't just hang out at lacrosse and never see each other. Like, we're with each other every day. We hang out after games. We go out together. Like, definitely some of my best friends from lacrosse team. So
I've always, like, been, like, connected to lacrosse, like, throughout my entire life. And not going and playing in a college is definitely going to be, it's going to be weird for me. I'm so used to walking home or coming into my house every day and seeing my stick and picking it up and, just messing around, and at school it's not going to be there, but we'll see what happens.
Well, playing for Bexley, you know, it's a close-knit community, so the guys you play with, you know, since you were a little kid, and it's really great just being able to get out on the field and play with them. Have a good time. I thought something fun we did this year was go down to Hocking Hills for a night and just hike around there, goof around, you know. Do some team building activities, and I think it brought us closer together, and it gave us some camaraderie.
Playing for Bexley means everything to me, because just know that I'm going out there with people that I like, respect, and I mean a lot to me. Like, this group of kids, really strong team and really strong camaraderie, and it means everything that I go out there and play with them and make an impact on the community as a whole, and hopefully the next couple of years that'll be stronger.
If Russo gets pissed and throws his hat, get away from that hat. And that's all you have to know about playing Bexley lacrosse. I don't know, it's just growing so much at Bexley. That's a positive sign. I wish I started earlier, but I didn't catch on quick enough, and I'd say Bexley has a good future in lacrosse. There's
a tree. For everyone else, I'm not gonna be back next year. I'm moving up to Cleveland this winter. So I'll see you guys. I'll come down during spring break.
Come watch some games.
But it's definitely been a pleasure. It's been a lot of fun watching you young men grow to men and watching some of you young men start to develop.
By the cracks of his skin, I climb to the top. I climb the tree to see the world. When the gods came around to blow me down, held on as tightly as you held on to me. Held on as tightly as you held.